For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for count when the deal's done.
I've got Keith Superstition Stitches. This is like an After Dark version. It's like really late. Keith is like, he was like in bed. He's awake now. Cedric is walking the streets of New York with stray dog, dope police sirens. But we're here because this was a great turn for commentators. We talked about everything ad nauseum in fall 1904, but not one of us in all our pontification theories thought that England would stab Germany. And look me here, boys. England caught Germany unawares. Germany writing a bunch of joke orders with all those armies surrounding Belgium. Meanwhile, England takes Helgoland, gets an army in Belgium with France's support into Paris. France takes Burgundy back. Biggest move of the game to Coke Animal. Was Coke Animal snorting Coke, or was this a good move? Keith?
I'm not too sure. I mean, he didn't cripple Germany. The only thing great is that the air is coming back, so it gives Germany something to worry about. But, I mean, for the most part, Paris is surrounded. It can be taken back, but I don't
okay.
know. Maybe he just thought that he might get stabbed, so he would stab back.
I had that thought, too. The might get stabbed or stab back, or maybe someone, some little demonic creature in Central Europe whispering that in his ear. I mean, I would like to push back on what Ed said, saying, you know, that Coke snorting things is a negative. I mean, he snorted Belgium and Paris right up. So I think snorting things is going quite well for Coke Animal. Secondly, the reason this board is so fascinating, just tell me that if any of these scenarios sounded plausible, right? Eastern triple, okay. Four-way alliance, Eastern triple with England. Fake German stab on England, where he just disbands that army in Paris and rebuilds. Like Western triple versus Eastern triple is even vaguely possible. Because that, you know, like they were like, okay, move out of Marseille and build that fleet. I mean, all of those sound plausible to me.
I think you're right. All of it is plausible. I don't think it's likely, but it's plausible. The Western triple thing is a little unlikely to me. I don't think we have a Western
triple. That's an outlier. That's an outlier. A late forming Western triple with a fake disband rebuild. But I mean, then again, Coke and Europe did that rebuild with Sweden. So there is a precedent.
I like how slow the AI went through. And then it's like they incorporated Russia and then it made it look like Russia wasn't in there. And now the AI are slowly rolling back. It's just how slowly it moves is kind of the beauty of it, because it's really not raising any suspicions until it's too late.
That really is the big story. I mean, there might be a distraction headline of England stabbing Germany, right? But what we really have here is continued AIR cooperation, where there was perfect deception with the forced taking of Caen. If they stick together, the West seems to be in complete turmoil. It almost seems like Caen's theory of a Western triple kind of has to happen right now. England and France have to stick together because of the Italian threat.
Yep.
Germany's got a bunch of Russian armies and now an Austrian army in Tyrolia at the doorstep. Hand, what's going to happen?
Oh, this is a much more familiar scenario, but also, I mean, this could also be what appears to be an Eastern triple and just be Austria pulling strings and really having an alliance with England too, because for one thing, look how many units Russia and Italy are sending west, and look how many units Austria is. Austria's sending one and everything else is staying in the east while they're sending three each. I mean, that seems like someone's dragging their feet a little bit. And then on top of that, I mean, I still think Austria is the one who leaked the move to France. I may have gotten a message that will be addressed in a in-game interview, but... And it just seems, you know, the pattern of Austria and England working together in the finals and elsewhere is so strong. I mean, could you see that be the late emerging key axis in this?
Maybe, but I definitely see that Riaz has quite a bit of help right now. in order to take the Black, Russia moved a fleet in. I mean, in order to take Ankara, Russia moved a fleet in. Russia's got three on Romania. If there's continued AI cooperation, I think there's an opening now for Austria. But what you're arguing is Austria-England, if I'm hearing you correctly, is the true alliance.
I mean, it's always better when you have a goal on the board to get other people to reach that goal for you. So if your goal is to keep England alive and you're Austria, how nice is it for Italy to attack France, Russia to attack Germany, while you very half-heartedly attack Germany and keep a lot waiting around in the back? Almost becoming the new Turkey. You know how Turkey's always the snake behind the lions? So I could see it. I mean, like I said, it was fascinating about this is how many options there really are. Is Stitches still here, by the way? Did he fall back asleep?
I'm still here.
You're really quiet. You have to, like, make comments.
Stitches is just like, Cedric's so smart, dude. Cool.
We need content, Stitches.
I like his stunned amazement at my words, though. It's kind of, like, pleasurable.
I can see a Western triple happening. It's remote, but, I mean, Europe's got two builds, so he's going to drop them probably in Berlin and Munich. It's not far-fetched.
Well, it's not far-fetched to think one forms now. I think Han was suggesting that this was part of the Western triple.
No, definitely not.
Okay, but Stitches, could you see this being a fake stab by England on Germany? Because Germany does get a rebuild.
I wouldn't see why Germany would need to. Germany gets two rebuilds.
Oh, he does?
Yeah.
Paris, well, he gets two. It's interesting that he gets two rebuilds right as a bunch of other powers move towards centers he can rebuild in.
The theory breaks down with England going to Helgel.
Yeah, pretty much. England would have to go to North or Norway.
All right, keep talking.
It would go to Norway. Oh, to threaten Russia. I see what you mean.
Yeah, if they were really working together.
I still suspect something. What, like, the joke order is suspicious to me. I know he did this the same thing with the VI order, where I was so convinced it was part of some master plan, like peace treaty between him and Riaz.
I think Italy.
I don't know, but who has the edge here?
What do you mean? Like, which power in the whole board?
Yeah, I mean, who benefits the most from this? I don't think it's a very good stab. I mean, it is a stab.
I think it's a fake.
I think England has the best opportunities for growth right now.
I think Italy, England and Austria
by far the worst. I don't think France and England are going to let Italy get anything.
I don't know, fellas. Like, England got Paris that he can't hold. He's traded his, you know, Belgian unit with four German armies for a Parisian unit with, you know, French armies all around it.
It's the same scenario pretty much, but he's going to have a build. He's probably going to have good leverage on Holland.
What do you think of the Italian attack?
I love a Midlisha support, but I think he overthought it a little bit. Like, why not just hit Gulf of Lyon? He would have even force disbanded it. Oh, no. I mean, I guess he could have retreated to Tunis, I mean, to Tuscany, but block that. You could have force disbanded that fleet. You don't even have to worry about it anymore. The militia support is fun, but it's such a guess when you have that guaranteed take almost, unless you think England's going to tap you.
I am shocked he didn't take Gulf of Lyon.
Same, but the fact that he didn't build in Rome to go to Tuscany to take it, for sure. I don't know. He's not prioritizing it at all.
I'm also a little shocked at the self-bound.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really bad. I mean, he still doesn't have a convoy line. He didn't take Gulf of Lyon it's almost like he's not trying that hard to push there, or doesn't want to move fully out of position, or maybe just, yeah, mistake. Who knows?
Well, I think he doesn't fully trust Riaz.
No, Riaz at least moved out of his center. He could have disbanded Lyon if he went to Tuscany. That would have given him a lot more pressure.
Doesn't look like there was coordination with Germany, which I understand if there's an heir that Germany wouldn't do that. But
no, it doesn't look like anyone's working with Germany this turn. He didn't support anyone for anything.
Here's what I don't understand. I'm dead serious. I don't understand the joke order of Paris. If Cedric is right, this is all a fake stab. You would have figured that England would be going for Brest.
Yeah, well, he tapped Gascony, so Brest was guaranteed.
Okay.
He didn't have to do anything with Paris.
I mean,
he's maintaining position in the mid-Atlantic. He's in a great position to stab France here. I think you guys are underestimating Europe. I mean, can we start talking about meta yet? Did you guys see that Europe used his mod powers to start an entire new channel called Finals Announcements and then announce some demands that we cover him more favorably?
I was so scrolling through the back channels, and I was like, "Where is this thing?" I did not read anything like that. But yeah.
And also, is he even watching our show? He said that I have to be nicer about him, and that Stitches is nice. It's like, what the hell are you talking about? I literally scolded Stitches because saying that he hates you, and because you probably stopped one of his solos or something. I really don't know, but usually.
Here,
no, Stitches, don't wrong Stitches. He'll literally never forget it. Like, I'm going to tell you that right now.
You're putting a target on his back by making him seem great. So your compliments are actually tanking his game. That's what he's pretty much.
Did I ever say he was good? I just said I liked watching his goofy play. But
It is very funny. I view it as an homage to the Protect Act and the Comment Act of Season 2 when I freaked out against Cedric. I'm not sure it's a great idea. We'll see. I mean, inside the game is a different story.
Well, and I've got to say it's really so you, because it was a not so subtle homage to you already, but you just couldn't let it go with such a light hand. You had to heavy-handedly repost all your writing from 5 years ago because it has to be about you, you know?
Well, I'm a narcissist. So, you know, the narcissist does as he does. All you have to do is compliment me. It's like, you know. No problem. Okay.
We're still working on that, yeah.
Yeah, I'm still unrequited from you, Cedric. All right. What about this attack by Russia as part of the air? This is a lot of trust Tanjian must have in Riyadh.
Yeah, that's par for the course for this map. Sanji has been trusting him nonstop, it seems like. Just waiting for the other shoe to drop. But it's been paying off so far, so hopefully he'll pick something up before he gets hit.
I would be a little unhappy about the hold in Budapest if I were Tanj, honestly.
Well, what does it matter? He could have moved to Galicia, but he's still got to build. He's going to build in Vienna.
I mean, if you're attacking Germany, shouldn't you move towards the line? Yeah, Galicia or something? You have
I don't think Russia wants to go to Galicia.
I mean, why do you need to stay in a position where you can take Romania like that?
No, I wouldn't like that either, but if he moves to Vienna, he builds in Budapest, it's the same problem, is all I'm saying.
That's true.
But
wait, is he getting a build here?
Yeah, he got Khan.
Yes.
All right.
And I then still France. Think he should move to Gao. Yeah, I'd want him to move to Galicia and then build in Vienna, no? Don't you think?
Yeah, but wouldn't you be worried he'd then build in Budapest? Now he's got huge stab possibility.
That's a good point. That's true. There's really, I suppose there's no way out once you let Austria get this far.
What he could have done is move Serbia to Trieste, especially since Jackson wasn't moving Venice anyways.
I mean, and then you put two on Venice.
Yeah.
This goes to show he cares more about Jackson than he does about Tanj.
It's a good point. Yeah. You know, like we were, like, I think Ewok's just laughing at me because it takes like 5 minutes for me to think that he's like, duh, I saw that in 5 seconds, you know, yeah. So
I think Rios treats all his allies equally. They all will get, you know, second.
And a lot of compliments.
Exactly.
All right. I think we got to give some kudos here to France. France lost Paris, kept Brest, kept Iberia, fantastic tactic, and most importantly, found a friend.
Oh my god, you guys, it is a Western triple. How are you guys not seeing it? Look at this. They disbanded two armies. He let them disband those two armies. I'm not crazy. Look at this move. Like, why would Europe do this? He let them disband two armies so he could rebuild them.
Well, I mean, he had two options of retreating, Picardy or Munich. And with all those armies coming at you, you're going to go to Munich. So you might as well just disband and have your choice of what to rebuild.
No, but what I mean is he didn't defend anything.
He didn't feel like he needed to.
I don't know. Okay, I'll stop. You're saying
the West finally figured out there was an heir.
I don't know if that's true or if it's just one of those convergent evolution moments where both sides of the wards decided it, or probably, of course, the complexity is deeper than that, but there's just something really, really suspicious going on. Come on. You have to at least, there is something suspicious here. This isn't the VI order.
Helgoland definitely makes me think that there's not a Western triple, but the fact that Paris didn't tap Gascony to protect Burgundy is kind of weird, because he could at least self-bound and he could have broke that support. So that's the only thing that I'm really seeing that
I would love weirdo Western triple versus loyal soldiers Eastern triple right here. Would be a great little mid-game deadlock for me. I know some people hate those kind of games, but...
You know, Cedric likes to talk about folds and thinking multiple folds ahead. And, you know, every conspiracy theory book in existence starts with the first question, who's to benefit? It seems to me this is a massive victory for Riaz if there is a Western triple. He's not committed to the line. He's got a good stab, not a good stab, but a potential stab against Russia, another potential stab against Italy.
I mean, there's kind of an old joke on the heart server about, you know, skinning another power and wearing their face. So he's basically done that to Turkey. He is the new lurker Turkey in the corner. And I think you're absolutely right. I'm with you all the way with that. This position benefits Rios.
Yeah, this whole map, the only thing that it benefits is England and Austria, right? Those are the only ones that really have a place to pick up.
Do you think anyone lied to Kunal on the last move?
Yes, I do. I absolutely think they...
He posted that like, Taylor Swift song, so I'm guessing that, yes, someone definitely... Everybody lied to him.
I mean, do you think that Tan Jian said, I'll put you into Khan and cut ball? And...
I think that once you lie every single turn, by the end, they probably lied to him, and he said, I know you're lying, but this is my last turn, and... Now, why not go for a clean sweep?
I don't think they lied. Otherwise, I think we would have seen Ankara support black to Khan. That would have been the lie. All right. It's the end of 1904. Russia does not build, if I'm reading this correctly. Austria gets a build, must build Army Vienna. Italy, no build.
No, they can build in Trieste.
Oh, will they build a fleet or an army in Trieste? I doubt it. They could, though.
Massive stab on Venice and Greece. Massive.
Oh, wow. Actually, if he built a fleet, that would be pretty bad, huh?
Does that France
No, I don't think so, though.
I don't think so.
I think the stab on Russia looks more immediately good.
Agreed.
I mean, he doesn't have... Yeah, like you just said, he could try to slip into Galicia. He could take Romania now. I mean... I'm kind of having trouble seeing how Russia could even retaliate unless he moves to Armenia preemptively or something.
Italy gets no build. France down one. Correct? Down one. Paris, I suspect they disband at Brest in light of this new cooperation between England and France. Cedric, any thought on France's disband?
God, I don't know. It really could be any... I really don't know. I mean,
If they get Europe on side, it could be Bergen. Brest makes more sense.
Now, I already know what Cedric is going to say.
I mean, if they were on side, they might want to keep Burgundy to help defend Munich. Sure. I mean, yeah, I guess you're right, Ed. Maybe Brest. I think that's the most likely. Gascony's too much of a linchpin. I mean, Portugal could be another option, but having the fleet there to help continue to fight Italy off seems too crucial. I don't think peace with Italy is possible while he's in that position. So I would say Brest, maybe Portugal.
What does England build? Cedric is fleet happy, loving England. I don't think Keith is as fleet happy with England as Cedric, but for me, it looks like a fleet is in order.
Yeah.
Although he's fighting Germany.
He has to get North Sea back, so I'm guessing fleet doesn't really matter. Probably EDI.
I am very fleet happy as England. I like to get the spiderweb out first, though. I know that's super out of fashion now. I dipped into some game Matt Krill was playing, and he had like 12 armies all in the center of the board and was waving fleet builds and building more armies. It was so weird to me anyway. But it has to be a fleet even beyond my pre-election, right? Because he has to fill Norway. I mean, that seems like the reason he moved to Helgoland, because nothing was threatening Norway and he could do that.
I like armies, but in the finals, I mean, you might just need fleets. So
I think a fleet is the right call. Germany rebuilds Zwei, too. I don't see how it's not Army Munich, Army Berlin. Well, you got a fleet in Helgoland. Does he go fleet army here, or?
How awesome would it be if he built two fleets? It's like everyone, all of you can fight over Munich. I'll be over here and just defend my stuff from the Baltic.
I guess it really depends if whether or not there's a late forming triple or not. Because there is a triple, it's two armies. If he's just really mad at Coke Animal, I think he could get back together with France at some level because France is going to want Paris back anyway. Fleet army makes sense.
He has to build two armies. I'm just kidding. I mean, he has the fleets where he needs them anyway. So yeah, he needs the armies. I would be tempted to kind of give up on Munich because this is, again, like my English fleet idea. This is super unpopular. Some people will say never give it up because it butts your, you know, it's the key to the board, it busts your centers. But for me, if everyone wants Munich, I say let them fight over that one dot. If I can hold the north easily, I might actually go that way. But he has to build two armies. I mean, he has the convoy vector through Baltic anyway. So if he wants to go after Russia, you can make him pull back with the convoy threat.
Well, let me ask you, Keith, you've been sort of raising the specter of a central triple. If there is a central triple and there is going to be a stab on Tange, if Germany knew for a fact, which Germany can't know, it's unknowable, but if Germany knew for a fact that Austria was going to stab Russia, if you were Germany, would you rather have a fleet, an army now, or two armies?
I don't think he has a choice but to do two armies. I mean, he might could get away with a fleet in Kiel, but I still think Army Munich, Army Berlin is better.
I think I'd be tempted with a fleet. And try and use diplomacy on my allies.
Would you do Army Munich or Army Berlin?
I would do Army Munich because I figure I could do something with Baltic or Denmark or, you know, I don't know.
Okay, maybe maybe if you're Ed, you could do that. But for every other person on Earth, they should probably build two armies. Let's not advise people to think they're you, man.
I'm just saying I would rely on my diplomacy. I agree it's a bad move.
You just like to hold people hostage is the thing. You're all like, right. I'm just going to do something so destabilizing that it will ruin the entire game if you guys don't meet my demands.
I can't play like that. Okay, great. For the whole fall season, Austria gets Khan in a deception play and still helps Tange into... by the way, we keep saying that Austria's going to stab Russia, and yet, why would he give Russia Ankara? And the only reason I can come up with is access to the Black Sea.
Well, it doesn't really matter. They won't get a bill, but...
Right. Well, it'd be nice to have a disband.
I would much rather have a Russian fleet in Ankara than in Turkish army.
Yeah. How do you grade him, fellas?
Do we grade him?
We're grading for the whole 1904 for Austria.
Oh, I like Austria. He's got an A. He's got a build. He has a free stab on whoever he wants. No enemies. He's great.
Definitely an A. Every single move is vaguely ambiguous and gives them options. Even the move to Tyrolia technically perks Germany from Italy, right? I mean, he's in a position where he can't really move to Bohemia with Italy. He has a stab position around Russia, which he can or might not use. He's wearing Turkey's face, as we mentioned, so has to be an A.
Did he tell Jackson he was moving to Tyrolia? Would he have been worried about Trieste not being covered?
I'm not sure. I would think so. I feel like the advantage he gets from that lie would be not enough to justify it.
Okay, I give Austria an A+. I think Cedric nailed him so perfectly by calling him the Godfather. Even though he's never seen the movie, which blows my mind.
Ed, can I tell you something else? I've actually never read the Protect Act either.
Oh my God. Well, we might have to read it here for remedial purposes, but in any event, he is Godfather. he's Marlon Brando Godfather, the nice Don. Everybody likes him, but he's got a ruthless side. Now we're waiting for Godfather 2, Michael, to come out of Riaz. That's when the knife really comes, and he's got that play in his playbook. But I think, okay, all around, Austria, great season. England, Coke Animal builds in Paris. We were asking, where's his growth? He showed us where his growth was from. He's got two armies on the continent. He's in Helgoland. He's building. He's got a friend in France, but he lost his friend in Germany. What do we grade him as?
I think I'm giving everyone in this amazing Decepticon Western triple an A. So I'm just going to, that's just my grade for all three of them. I'll even pass beyond that. I mean, the German rebuild, the move to Helgoland that's going to pass through Kiel to attack the East, you know, the cooperation to defend Spain. They all get an A. It's a mutual A, unless I'm completely wrong, and then they maybe all get a C.
I'm going to give him a B. He got a build. Looks like he has some follow-through. He gained an ally with France. So I think that if he didn't stab and just took Brest, that Germany would have enough pressure that he would be in a better position. I don't think he knew that the heir was going to come across the line. Otherwise, it might have been more beneficial to stay with Germany. So,
okay, actually, real talk. I mean, I would, even if he was just in it for himself, I would give him an A, because he could stab Germany and then still take Brest, right? I mean, he could just be going into coke animal mode and just start snorting this all up regardless. You know, the East is kind of pressuring the others and he's in the corner, so that's possible too. God, this board is just scrambling my brain. I'm sorry.
Yeah, but right now you need France, because right now France is the only thing stopping Italy from growing.
I'm going to give him a B plus, and I bet you coke animal doesn't feel like he got a B plus. I'm looking at this game, and because it's all about me and I'm a narcissist, but this England is a chaos agent. What it does is it just keeps him relevant. I don't think he was relevant a season ago. And I mean, now honestly, people got to work with him.
I mean, he has Mid-Atlantic, English Channel, and he's going to have the North Sea and Heligoland. That's an A to me. I mean, just having those four.
How is he not relevant a season ago? Every season he's become more and more relevant.
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
He is a snowball. He is an avalanche.
He's a coke animal.
This is revisionist history. We were all talking about how he was out of position. Should Germany stab?
And he kept pivoting every time.
Well, we didn't say it. Like, I think you know, he gets a good grade for no other reason than outguessing us. Tarsier.
Okay, excuse me, sir. I did not say Germany should stab. That was, but yes, let's continue.
That's fair. Tarsier's grade.
I will also give him a B. He got an ally finally, but he lost the center. So he's pretty much relegated to being a defensive wall on the stalemate line for the short term.
I mean, I'd give him a B plus, even though he's in a really bad spot, because it's a miracle that he only lost Paris this turn. I mean, that is a success. I did not see that coming.
You didn't have to lose Paris. If he sold the stab to England, could have retaken it, right? I think it's a wise play that he didn't take it. He prioritized the friendship, at least with England, if Cedric's right, with everybody in the West. I'm going to give France an A+. Here's the reason why. I thought the fleet build in Marseille was insane. I think he had the defense all wrong. I would have never played it this way. And he showed a better path forward. He did something really good. And
oh my God. Sorry, go on.
But anyways, I think he deserves a lot of credit. And he turned a guy around. Cedric, something important? We have a criminal attacking you now?
No, I just still, this board is just killing me. I was just still thinking about the move to Helgoland and how it's so funny that that England and Germany moved in a way where they don't threaten each other as much. And well, it might have been to not threaten Russia. Who knows? Sorry. Yeah. We can move on grades.
Does this move set make sense? Like, wouldn't it make more sense to put France into Paris and just give England Spain or something, get the position forward, less aggression, less conflict? Then Brest is an MAO or a DMZ. You could push Picardy into Burgundy instead.
I mean, look, I know you guys think I'm crazy, right? But think about it this way. Let's say we were the three Western powers. You know how when you're really entangled, it's hard to make peace and pivot? What would be the literal fastest way to disentangle and pivot would be to do this.
You would have the same result, though.
But I mean, you could build in Berlin, for instance. Anyway, yeah, maybe I'm
crazy. If Picardy supported Brest to Paris, and you know, you'd have the same thing. Or, yeah, I don't know.
All right. Ultimately, yeah, let's move on. Did you give France a grade, Cedric? Or does he gets an A?
I said a B plus because it's a miracle that he only lost one center, no matter what's going on.
All right. Germany's grade. I'm pretty sure Cedric's going to give him the first A triple plus of the season.
I think I just enjoy being disoriented and confused too much. I mean, I feel like I'm looking at Germany.
Why is that so shocking for me to hear?
Yeah, I'm just looking at Germany's play. And I think I said in the chat, I compared him to a kind of quack doctor who's selling you all kind of dubious medicines. And that's what I have no idea what's going on 90% of the time with him. Can you guys give him the grades first? Because I really don't know right now.
I'm giving him an F triple minus. I think this is a complete disaster. I do not think that Europe did anything other than a major screw up. But
I'm going to give him an F, and I hate that because Europe is better than that. Because he's wasting units' moves. Like, he could have self-bounced in Belgium. You know, that still protects his ally, which prevents that convoy. He could have done something with Paris. Like, these joke moves are just beneath him. Like, he is an expert tactician, and he should have done something with his move.
I think you're slightly underestimating how much Europe loves attention, though. I think, you know, there was something in the commentary about how Kunal, by selecting Turkey 5th, had joined the ranks of VI's joke order and Riaz's whole build, and Europe was just like, hold my beer, I don't like this. They're paying too much attention to him. And
yeah, this is very similar.
But if this was all planned in a way to build in Berlin, what would you give him? Just hypothetically speaking.
And... A triple plus.
Really?
Actually, I'm not sure. Because, like, did he need to do this? Or could he have just had the same effect by taking Norway and Belgium, getting his two worlds? Does he really want to face the air and still have England be poking him from behind?
I don't know. He's telling England, here, you can just fight France. And I'll go this way.
I don't know. That Helgen move just blows any coordination thought out of my mind.
I mean, it does look a lot like he wants to convoy straight into Kiel or something.
Okay. Jackson, Italy, his grade. He gained no centers. He did not lose Greece. He did not lose Smyrna, which I guess was theoretical. And he had an ineffectual Western attack. I'm a C for Italy this season.
I really don't like this. I have to give him a D. I mean, just all across the board, the malicious support is overthinking things in a long shot where you could just take Gulf of Lyon.
He would have been done better coordinating with England than guessing, which means he doesn't have a friend over there at all.
I think the self-bounce is a little static. I think that it just supporting Khan with Smyrna is being a bit of a doormat. I mean, I would say, cool. I trust you guys. I'm going to the Aegean, and from there I can protect my centers a lot better. And it shows trust. So I just don't like it across the board. I mean, I'm not going to give him an F just because his position is good. And in some ways it's just a defensive keeping as many fleets out as possible. I mean, even if he had just moved to Aegean and had all those blue tiles lined up like that, I would like this, but
I think if he moved to Aegean and dropped Venice to APU, he'd have a ton of convoy options at least.
Yeah, exactly. He seems to just constantly miss that the value, not necessarily of doing convoys, but of having possible ones and how that affects the board. I feel like he's really missing those opportunities.
He had a great pivot west. I think France got that, used that to get Coke Animal on its side. But right now, Italy is just stopped. And they're spread out. They're in the same position they were before, whereas Smyrna and Greece are pretty much indefensible.
Stitches, does this England-Italian position look familiar to you?
Yeah, it's real. Coke Animal, if you're in Tyrrhenian Sea and Italy gives you a deal, don't take it. Just take a centers.
All right. Tangian, and I'm really torn because we all love Tanj. I've been critical of his Ewok style play, and then when he moves, now I'm saying he shouldn't have moved. It seems like really unfair criticism of him, but I'm not a huge fan of the move. I'm not. But he was going to go down, and he got Ankara. I really hope for him that Riaz is onside.
Yeah, I mean, I've been pro no moving for him since the beginning, so I continue to disapprove of this over movement. He should just follow his Sensei Ewok's teachings and just continue to hold.
Yeah, it's a D for me as well. I mean, Riaz has both his allies just overextended, and it's wonderful. They're just out of position, and they're just pushing the front with him.
You know what's the worst part is the move to Prussia.
Prussia's... Yeah, I would like to see that convoy to Finland.
Yeah, exactly. Prussia's just not a great tile. Finland is a wonderful, wonderful place for a guerrilla war in the north. So,
boy, and I was going to say, I didn't like the Warsaw move.
I didn't like that one either. I would have held.
Well, either support Romania or move to Galicia. And I know Austria wouldn't like that, but it still protects Romania. It is still, you know, movement. But I understand why you couldn't do that. But I'm just not a big fan of that move. I don't know. There's like a lot.
I mean, you're right too, because just why cover that center? Why take that off the board? You know, you could build Warsaw anyway, couldn't you? So
no, he doesn't get a build.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, because he's exchanging. Good point. So I don't hate the move to Warsaw. I don't love it. I mean, I think Moscow would have been defensive and given a lot of options. That would be much more in the Ewok playbook anyway.
Well, I'm just like...
And my playbook.
Either Romania is valuable to you or not. I think he's signaling it's not. If it's not, then Sev can go to Ukraine or, So he wants it, but he doesn't really want it. Now we're going to find out.
I felt like they should just convoyed Romania to Ankara and just drop the Black Fleet into Romania. And then Riaz could actually demilitarize.
I mean, is it old-fashioned of me to think Russia should go north or south? I mean, going into Germany first never seems to end well from what I've seen. I feel like, yeah, the convoy to Finland and would have been a stronger play. I don't know. I don't really like just attacking Germany through the center when you have no other options and you're leaving yourself vulnerable.
Could you imagine if Tans went to Baltic here? That would have been awesome.
He should have. I mean, I if I was actually going against Germany, I would be doing that over and over again until I get it.
We agree. If that had happened, we'd be giving him an A+. Like, that would be good.
But on the other hand, if Germany would have stabbed Norway, then Sweden would have been open. So that ensures Germany doesn't go up if they do decide to stab.
Look, I just have a fundamental. The way I play Russia is, you're right, they have to go north or south. And you have a lot of growth opportunity north. But if you're weak in the south, it's very hard to board top.
Yeah, I mean, you just end up trapped in the north and on three centers, I think.
And Riaz is about to have five armies, most likely.
I mean, I see no reason for Riaz to attack Germany. Like,
none.
The story does not make...
Germany has no friends.
What do you mean? He sent one entire army into Tyrolia to, like, charge forward with his heroic Eastern Triple. Like, here, guys, I'll help you. Oh, wait, I left something in the tent. I'll be right back.
Hold my beer. Okay, Kunal, we say goodbye to Kunal, that fresh-faced, doughboyish kid who had so much enthusiasm, our top seed, our solo artist who predicted a solo in this game, who dropped fifth, I think, to take Turkey. Even though he said in his interview he wanted Austria because it couldn't be attacked by water. I absolutely love this guy. I think he's great for the game.
He achieved a solo center.
He has not had a good game. We don't give you a grade if you get knocked out. You just get our ridicule.
Well, but, he gets to join the illustrious club of fresh-faced finalists with the first seed who thought they were going to solo in the finals and were eliminated by the end of 1903. So welcome, Kunal. Like, I am vice president of that club. Just hit me up, you know.
I thought you were talking about Conk. But
I was actually talking about me and Stitches, and I guess
I did it in season one, but I got taken about fast.
All right. Wow. Well, this is interesting. Kunal will be interviewed. We'll hopefully try and do that over the weekend. I don't know when we'll broadcast the interview, depending on the information leak. But thank you, Kunal, for playing. We are down to six. It is a very even six. I have no more comments on the game except to say, keep doing what you're doing, competitors. We appreciate it. Fellas.
My final prediction is that Riaz becomes the first person to win a Nexus Finals with six.
Good night, fellas.
Good night.
Good night, guys.
Now every gambler knows the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser. The best you can hope for is to die in your sleep.